So we're in a gondola on the way up to Mount Pilatus, and you, so you can see down below is the town of Klins and Lucerne over in the distance, and right now it's very snowy, but you know, you gotta have snowy days like this to build up a good base for skiing. We're gonna go all the way to the top of the mountain, and it should be interesting. We won't be able to see the vistas, but you know, it's fun. Having a good time, having some hot chocolate in the gondola.
It's minus 10 up here. What's really interesting is that this hotel over here was built in the 1800s, and all the materials were brought up on donkeys' backs because the train and the gondolas obviously did not yet exist.
When you look around here, you see it feels kind of very surreal. It's snowing, it's very cold, there's sort of fog, and then the sun comes out over here, so you get this really odd light here. It's kind of magical. Yeah, and she was explaining, like, the three cantons meet here. She said that the old name of Pilatus was Mons Fractus, so in Latin this means like broken mountain, so it's very jagged and ruggedy, and you can see right in the name there, it's kind of cool. And then you have this modern hotel, really neat. I love the light.
And where did you go?
So we're here at the Hotel Bellevue, and we're having a lunch of local delights at the Slow Food Restaurant. So Chef Mark went in the kitchen with the chef to talk about what we're having for lunch.
Hello, Chef.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, and you?
Good. So what is it like to work up high in the mountains?
It's nice, because when it's the weather, it's better. It's the best view.
And you get to do a very typical menu here, yes?
Normally, yes. Normally we make an apple macaron or sausages, special kind, or fondue, raclette, the special kind of Switzerland.
So, Chef, can you tell us a little bit about the pasta you're making for us today?
Yes, it's with pasta, it's with cheese, cream, garlic, onions, a little bit muscat, salt, pepper, and to the discoming apple mousse, and dry onions too.
I think that's the interesting part. The apple is a component
sweet.
Of the dish.
Yes, because of the sweet and sour, it fits very much to the little bit mountain style.
Yeah, yes. Yeah, the particular palate of Switzerland.
Yes.
So it makes it different from pasta from other places. Wonderful, we look forward to eating it. All right, so we're tucking in here, and this is great. What I love about this is that if you can see here, they do a crunchy onions on top. There's bits of potato and the pasta, and then the applesauce is really what makes it special. So what I've done is I'm getting a little bit of each element, and you just dip it in the sauce. The apple has a nice sweetness, which really it goes with the cheese and the texture of the onions here. I mean, the paprika, the way it was presented, of course, is great. I just think this is a wonderful, very homey dish for this kind of winter day.
Well, we just got presented with the most gorgeous dessert. This is a frozen chocolate cream, and there's the Alpine version of a gooseberry here. And there's enough here for quite a few people, but this is my portion. If you come here, don't just come up and see the view, though it is beautiful. This is a great place to stay for some peace and quiet and a great meal.